My dudes, touchy subject time. Let's talk about a sensitive topic. Today we're gonna talk about taking the big risks. Yeah, baby. Oh yeah, it's gonna be exciting. But first up, it's summertime, and that means there's a big sale going on over on my Gumroad channel where I have all of my tutorials from beginner to pro. You can use that code on the screen for 30% off. Also, a portion of any profits go to helping out the pups. They go to helping out abandoned or abused animals with the ASPCA. All right, let's get into it, man. A lot of times, you know, you're thinking, you're seeing all this beautiful artwork online and you've got some skill with it and you're thinking, man, you know, if I didn't have my job, you know, I could do this. And then you go online and a lot of other artists will tell you, yeah, man, yeah, you should just go for it, man. You should just drop everything else and just go for it. Just drop everything. Just quit your job. Full steam ahead. Nothing else matters. Abandon your kids. Forget your love life. They say that means you're committed. They say, don't worry about paying rent. Don't worry about paying your mortgage. Don't worry about investing in your future, retirement, or planning for any kind of a future, because it's all or nothing, right? Go for your art dreams. And I think that is awful advice. I think that is the worst possible advice that anyone could give you. If they care about you at all, they should be telling you to stand on solid ground while you pursue your dreams. And I know, it's hard. It's hard to put together a portfolio and every night come home from your job and put time into that focused thing and put the video games down and put the books down and put the Netflix down and focus on your craft so that you can get a job, so that you can get employment as an artist or build out your business as an artist. I know that's tough. That's hard freaking work because I've been in it. I've done that in my life. And you're probably thinking, well, Trent, what do you know about it, man? You always had it easy. You've been a rock star since you were 16. Well, guess what? When I was little, my dad really wanted to be in a rock band. We had no income. We were banking everything on my dad, his band blowing up. And he didn't want to work a regular job. He wanted to be a rock star, right? So he risked it all. That's not unreasonable for a 25-year-old man to make that choice, but he had two kids at home. Let's just say things didn't quite work out and it made it real rough on us as a family. And I certainly wish that maybe back then my dad could have watched a YouTube channel about a guy telling him, hey man, don't bank at all and risk your whole family's safety and security on your dream of being an artist, a musician. You see where I'm going with this? You see where I'm going with this? Because I'll never forget being poor. I'll never forget waking up and seeing the fish tank frozen in a block of ice because they shut the heat off. If you got kids, man, you got a bigger responsibility than your art dreams. Especially if you think that you're just gonna kind of get discovered from making great stuff. That's not enough. Successful artists, successful YouTubers, they have strategies. They have plans in place. They've done the research on the business of it, and they're making money enough to take a calculated risk. If you've got none of those, then you might as well try to be a rock star or a football player. Just, you know what? Just play the lottery. If you're going into the art game with no strategy, you are gambling. And if you are gambling, you can pretty much expect to think of it like it's a lottery. That's really the hard work that most artists don't want to do. They don't want to research the business or how to monetize what it is that they're making. And if you're really averse to the business side, then dude, just do it as a hobby. Do it on the side. Do it as something that's just fun to do on the side. No expectations. That's the way to live. Gunga la gunga. And hey, you know, as a part-time thing, maybe that could take off. Maybe that could blow up. But if you don't, you still had a great time. But you know what? You didn't sacrifice your family to do it. And that's true with an art career too. You can have a side business selling t-shirts with your art on it while working at the shoe store, while working at that office job crunching numbers every day. More importantly, while making your bills, while providing for your family, while planning for a stable financial future. And that's the strategy that I do endorse. Pay the bills, be responsible, be a good parent, but do a side business where you're selling your t-shirts, maybe you only make one sale every other few days or something like that, but that's something you can grow. You can build out from that. And then once that has enough steady ground, then you can take a little bit more of a vested interest in it because it's calculated. You're standing on solid ground. Maybe you've got a product with your art on it and you're selling those and you're figuring out how to market it and how to find the audience that wants that. Or maybe you're starting to get some traction with some game developers. You're working on an indie game and it's actually making some money. That's when you can start to take those bigger risks, slightly bigger risks. I also wouldn't encourage anybody to take a big debt on, you know, don't like quit your job and put it all on a credit card because you think in 6 months your Instagram is going to suddenly make enough money to pay for it all. Mm-mm. Do you know what Instagram pays? $0. Don't go and rack up a bunch of debt on expensive equipment. You set yourself up in a negative momentum if you do that. If you start building debt at a young age, that is the opposite of what you want to be doing in life. For every dollar that you put yourself in debt, your future self will have to pay back $2. But if you're investing in your future, then your future self will be thanking your younger self. All of these people out there tell you, oh, you know, just borrow money to make it happen. Oh, you got to have all this expensive equipment. You don't have to have expensive equipment to make great art or have a creative mind or to make a product that people want from you. You don't need an expensive house or an expensive car or expensive clothes for people to respect you. Your family, your kids, they're going to appreciate having you available much more than they're going to appreciate having a famous parent. I talk about this so passionately, by the way, because I am the product of all of this, okay? Not angry about it, but it's painful to watch so many people go, yeah, I'll just, you know, I'll finally be there for my family when I'm famous or when I'm rich or after I've accomplished my art dreams. Don't do that to your kids, man. Don't do that to the people that you love. And don't do that to your future self. If it seems risky, like I might lose, you know, the current stability that I got, I don't take those kind of risks. I have to have multiple sources of income. My backup plans have backup plans, man. When you start creating something like a comic book on the side or a t-shirt business on the side, you're calculating out your cost versus your profits. You're calculating out an advertising budget, and then it has X amount of dollars of return on every ad and every dollar spent on ads. And this means you're going to have to do some reading about building a business, about how to market, how to create a product and market. I would recommend starting with The 4-Hour Workweek by Tim Ferriss. And reading books about this stuff just becomes part of your everyday routine. Being a successful artist, having a successful business is so much more about the business than it is about the art itself even. Any financial stability that I have came from my own resourcefulness and from planning and strategizing so that I'm never on unstable ground. I do not take huge risks with my career, which isn't exactly exciting advice. Like, there's a really popular YouTube channel about a guy who gambles on day trading on the stock market, and people love to watch while he loses $500,000 a day or gains $500,000 a day. But it doesn't matter to that guy because he's got $100 million. But to the average user, it's like exciting. It's like gladiator shit. It's like he's going into the arena. Is he going to die today? Is he going to lose more money than I've ever seen in my life? And I'm saying you don't need that. You don't need that kind of crazy ass life. You don't need that. It's too risky. I've seen too many people lose it all. The high stakes game is for suckers. You know, I also want to say, like, this can come across as very harsh, but as I said, I gave you the warning. This is a tough topic. I talk about it because I care. And I care because I get a lot of letters from people who are still struggling with this. I don't want to see you suffer. I don't want to see the people that love you suffer watching you fall down a hole because society told you you have to bank everything on your dream. The measure of success is not how much money you have or the expensive cars or fancy houses or number of subscribers or even having your name buried in the credits of some mega successful game. It is more valuable for you to be a loving father or a loving mother or a loving husband or wife. It is more valuable for you to have stability, to have the heat on all through the winter, to have food in the refrigerator, nutritious food, to take care of your family, to take time out, to enjoy playing with your kids, to have a strong family unit, to know that they can count on you, than for you to be a successful artist. Because even once you get that, you know, once you accomplish all of your art dreams, there's just more art dreams. There's something else that you're going to want to do. So focus the important thing on what's actually important, your family, your relationships, and your health too. I firmly believe that you can take care of all those things, prioritize those things, and accomplish all of your art dreams on the side without losing sight of what really matters. Be safe out there. Keep the dream alive, but be responsible, okay? I'm looking out for you, man. That's what I do. I look out for you. The artwork that you're watching me do is for The World of Twilight Monk, Volume 2. This is another art book, and these images are based on the universe of Twilight Monk, and you can read about the adventures of Twilight Monk over on my other YouTube channel. You can follow the link on the screen right now. It's an audiobook. I'm basically doing audiobooks over on my other Aquatic Moon channel. Check it out. All right, dudes, that's it for me on this week's video. If you want to check out my other channel, I'm up to the second book. I'm already writing the fourth book that I'm going to do on that channel, and chapters are coming out every week. So dudes, I'll see you over there, and I will also see you here next Mañana Bond. And dudes, until next time, ciao, baby. Oh, yeah.